How preferential votes are counted. For the lower house of state parliament and many local councils where you're electing one councillor for your ward, the preferential voting system is used to count votes. This means that to be elected, a candidate must achieve an absolute majority of the total number of formal votes. In other words, more than 50% of the total formal votes. For example, if 20,000 votes are cast, the winner needs 10,001 votes. The votes are allocated to each candidate based on the voter's first preference, or where they have put the number one. After they have all been sorted, the number of votes for each candidate is counted. If no candidate has achieved an absolute majority, more than 50%, a preference distribution is conducted. To do this, the candidate with the lowest number of votes is excluded. The excluded candidate's votes are inspected and allocated to the next preferred candidate, or where the voter has put the number two. After this, the totals are counted again. If there is still no absolute majority, the next lowest scoring candidate is excluded, and again, their votes are redistributed to where the voter placed the number two. If the second preferenced candidate has already been excluded, then the third preference is considered, and so on. This process is continued until one candidate receives an absolute majority of votes and is elected. So make sure you have really thought about your preferences, because around half of the lower house and council electorates are won on preferences. For further information, visit vec.vic.gov.au or call 131 832.